Alright, so
I hate decaf.
Sounds perfect. Everything sounds good, and now we're gonna start. So
I have been coaching for, I would say, the last 6 to 7 years. I've been here 14 years total, so I gotta probably figure out the math in my head, but probably about half that time.
I started the opportunity of coaching around 2008, 2009, had a great call in the middle of my day that said, "Hey, what are you doing? Get over here. Some people need some help."
There you go. You know, I would say probably one of the biggest things is, and it's a subconscious thing that people don't really realize that they're holding on to, is when you come here and come to learn a new system, a new process, some of it may be something you've already been exposed to before somewhere else or that you already incorporate, but for a majority of the people, that's not the case. So part of it is the subconscious ego, right, getting in our way, where if I do things new here as opposed to the way I used to do them, then I'm saying old me or old Justin, if you will, is wrong. And a lot of times our ego doesn't like to be wrong, and it's a hard hill for us to overcome, especially subconsciously and kind of mentally in our head.
Yeah, I'd say the biggest thing is understanding you can do more than one thing a day. I think so many times newer agents, they are not used to the pace of doing more than one appointment a day. And really they need to be prepared to do 2 to 3 appointments a day and get busy quickly, because they're here to make a lot of money. We sell houses here, and doing one appointment a week is not going to get you where you want to go. I think for me, it comes down to the hands-on field training and mentoring, and really try to understand what is it that they think has held them back in the past, and really go to the question behind the question, because so many times people aren't even aware. And there's all areas of our lives, or every one of us, even us as coaches, we need to improve. We're not perfect by any means, but we definitely know how to sell real estate. And we've coached people to sell, you know, 50, 60 homes a year. We've had people sell a few homes a year. If you want to sell homes, if you give us a clear idea of what it is you want to do and why you want to get there, and you will follow instructions, believe me, we can get you there.
So one of the best parts about he and I is that our personalities aren't totally the same. So we definitely look at things from different angles, and then that helps because we're also dealing with multiple types of personalities, sometimes even legally multiple different personalities of people. But anyway, so that way we, again, we can help them with the way that they're looking at things and the way that they're seeing things. The main way with that is we just gotta kind of gauge what's their big why. Why are they in real estate? What are they trying to accomplish? So then that way we can tailor the coaching to that. So it's kind of like someone who wants to lose 10 pounds versus someone who wants to gain 5 pounds. You're not going to put them on the same regimen. So that way we can look at what they're trying to accomplish, and then we can figure out what the regimen or what the plan is to accomplish wherever they want to get to. Well, you know, it's kind of like with any new skill or any new muscle. You know, at first it takes a little bit to build it, and it's uncomfortable, right? So if you've never ran more than a mile and you decide you want to run 2 miles, a mile one to mile two is going to be very uncomfortable. But in that uncomfortable space, that's where you get the most growth. So I think we'll all agree that whenever we're working out or wherever we're trying to learn something new, as it gets harder, that's again where the growth comes, where the knowledge comes. So I think the biggest thing is for people to be able to push through the uncomfortableness, because it's kind of like if you're right-handed, when you write right-handed, you come in here and learn how to write left-handed, it's gonna be way uncomfortable at first. But after 3 weeks, after 4 weeks of writing only left-handed, all of a sudden you're gonna be pretty good, right? Willing to not only say I'm willing to be uncomfortable, but actually do it.
Yeah, I would say it's about becoming a bold risk taker and being willing to make a mistake and understand, as your spotters, we're here to catch you. You know, we go on appointments with people until they're comfortable going on their own. We role play all these appointments. buyers, sellers, you can shadow us. I mean, we do everything we can to get people up and running as fast as possible and get them successive. If it's successful, as long as you're willing to do the work, it always comes down to, are you willing to do the work? For us, we've got a catalog of online training mm-hmm. materials, but we take it another step further. I mean, we role play the materials in a classroom and we do it live in the field. So, for example, it's one thing for me to tell you, go do an open house. It's another thing for me to go spend 4 to 6 hours with you, showing you how to pick the house, showing you how to put up the signs, showing you how to greet people at the door, showing you how to capture their contact information, show them houses, tour homes, open negotiations, and take them through the process. I think our training is so comprehensive that if you're willing to do the work, there's no way you could not be successful. Mm-hmm. The only factor we don't know about is your willingness yep. to do the work. Other than that, this is a constant and never-ending environment of pushing up people. We're created this leadership factory for those people that want to create their own team and be successful. They absolutely can crush it.
One of the best things about the Curtis Johnson team is we have the best of everything, right? So, you know, we have online technology that we can leverage. We have hands-on training, like he had mentioned, as well as manuals and other materials. So we cover all the different spectrums because we do know that people don't learn live trainings. People don't learn the exact same way. We have all of that covered so that way, you know, people can dive into their particular learning styles and have them, you know, have it click and have them get it in their head. I think too, you talk a lot about the lecture in the lab, and that's really one of the ways that we can really help prepare people for when they get out in the field, they know what to do and they can be ready to go. You know, I think for me, it's a constant, right? It's not any one specific thing, but I think for me, I really enjoy when people are able to leverage the processes and systems that we put in place and the strategies and the coaching that we give people to be successful. And, you know, it's almost like a little kid right at Christmas when, like, it works, you know, in their head, because we all have kind of prejudgment and we all have kind of wounds internally that we're trying to accomplish that, you know, we want to think it maybe doesn't work, right, until we see it work. A lot of times we have a personality that I won't believe it till I see it. So it's actually quite enjoyable when people follow a system and process and have success and they're like, oh my God, it worked, it was great.
Yeah, I think the most exciting piece for me is that we've dealt with so many different agents over the years and coaching them differently based on their skill sets, that we've created systems that are totally supportive for all different personality styles, for different communication styles, for whether you want to work from home remotely or whether you want to come to the office every day. I remember we had specifically an agent that had gone on about 20 buyer appointments, and he just was having no luck writing any offers, and he was really struggling. And we sat down and immediately responded with a tool that is now used by all the agents on the team, and everybody loves this tool, and it really minimized the number of homes people need to show before they start opening negotiations. So I really love the responsiveness to the training, so that if somebody on the team will just trust that we can get you there, if they're having any pitfalls or stumbles, just communicate, share it with us. We will respond. The training is so responsive to get you right back on track mm-hmm. where you need to be. Or we can explain why you're not getting the results you need because you don't have a good enough understanding of the technique. And so I love how responsive the training is. We're looking for people that are not just curious. I mean, we want people committed, right? Mm-hmm. People that are committed to growth, they're not interested in real estate, they're actually all in and really want to make a go of this as a career. I'm looking for coachable people. Mm-hmm. And what sometimes people are just chokeable because they already think they know it. And if they knew it, then they'd be successful where they are. And so if they would trust us that we will get you to the skill set you need to get your production to where you say you want it to be.
To coach.
You know, I think one of the ones that are the most fun and the ones that have the most success are the ones that come in and again, they're willing to learn. They're willing to be uncomfortable. They want to work hard. right? And we're not talking about, you know, a part-time job type work hard, but they're willing to work hard. And again, be uncomfortable and being willing to learn. Because as you learn the system, as you learn the process, like James mentioned earlier, is that, you know, there's gonna be failure, right? You gotta be able to accept there is gonna be failure before you have victory. That's just how it is. So for someone that is open to the coaching, open to the systems and processes and willing to grow within them, and again, not fight it, right? Just being willing to come in and trust us and leverage it for 6 weeks, right? Just come in and put your head down and work hard for 6 weeks. Those are the most fun because they see results pretty quickly. And then of course the buy-in comes pretty quickly after that as well. So those are the most fun ones because then you don't feel like you're dragging them. You feel like you actually are climbing Mount Everest and you are tied together as a rope. And we're both trying to get where you want to get to, and it makes it a lot of fun.